Charlotte Makgomo Mannye Maxeke. Her parents went to the Cape. She grew up there, she went to school. It came out that her voice came out very well. So some elderly people around there, teachers or leaders, encouraged her that they should sing around, you know, within South Africa. Then at a later stage, of course, they were sent abroad to England and so forth. It wasn't an easy environment. She was a woman, a mother. We believe that, you know, women have got a very big role to play by influencing the people around us. They don't have to be your sister or anything else. As long as if it's a woman, we always want to come together and then discuss our issues, which bring us together. So Charlotte was such a person. She took note of the kind of life that she lived in South Africa. Because at that time, our continent was still very dark, as they put it, and we were very much at a disadvantage. It needed somebody with a very big courage to go through all of these rough waters, you know, to try and sort of prepare things for the world at large. She fought. She mixed with women and other people who were in the churches. She mixed with people who worked in the community to bring everybody together to discuss the issues that are at stake with us. And therefore, that in itself, being more people coming together, discussing and fighting together, she found her way in gaining some of the things that we got for ourselves, like the laws, how we should be regarded, how we should be respected, and that we too should respect other people, regardless of their tradition or race or anything. As we were at school, we used to correspond with the people at home. There were people who used to talk to us and tell us about the problems that people are suffering here at home, which we also saw, but because we're in a boarding school, it wasn't very easy. So it was then that one felt that, no, each time when you go for the holidays, there should be a meeting. We should discuss these issues together with those at home and see what activities we should do to, you know, try and fight together. When I came to teach here at Pimville High School, then there was Bantu education that was introduced, you see. And I, as a teacher, I had to take part in it. That is when I started to be very, very active, seeing that, you know, when it comes to Bantu education, I'm sorry, I cannot take part in that one. So that is how my political, this thing came up. And then, of course, we knew that if you are going to fight a thing, you have to have meetings, you must discuss. We worked together with men, by the way, but as women, we concentrated on things that were on us, especially. So we said, you know, women as people who bring life to this world have a duty to see that this world, this life is preserved and protected. And that cannot be done by a woman who is maybe from somewhere else. It can be done by women who come together. Whether you're a churchgoer, you're not a churchgoer, a teacher, educated or not educated, we needed to come together because our yearnings for our children is the same and our problems in our homes are the same. And therefore, the only best way to do is to come together and fight as a collective. And that we learned from Charlotte, following after her steps. When I came to teach here at Pimville High School, then there was Bantu education that was introduced, you see. And I, as a teacher, I had to take part in it. That is when I started to be very, very active, seeing that, you know, when it comes to Bantu education, I'm sorry, I cannot take part in that one. So that is how my political, this thing came up. And then, of course, we knew that if you are going to fight a thing, you have to have meetings, you must discuss. We worked together with men, by the way, but as women, we concentrated on things that were on us, especially. So we said, you know, women as Charlotte, Makgomo, Mannye, Maxeke. Her parents went to the Cape. She grew up there, she went to school. It came out that her voice came out very well. So some elderly people around there, teachers or leaders, encouraged her that they should sing around, you know, within South Africa. Then at a later stage, of course, they were sent abroad to England and so forth. It wasn't an easy environment. She was a woman, a mother. We believe that respect other people, regardless of their tradition or race or anything. As we were at school, we used to correspond with the people at home. There were people who used to talk to us and tell us about the problems that people are suffering here at home, which we also saw, but because we're in a boarding school, it wasn't very easy. So it was then that one felt that, no, each time when you go for the holidays, there should be a meeting. We should discuss these issues together with those at home and see what activities we should do to, you know, try and fight together. But, you know, women have got a very big role to play by influencing the people around us. They don't have to be your sister or anything else. As long as if it's a woman, we always want to come together and then discuss our issues, which bring us together. So Charlotte was such a person. She took note of the kind of life that she lived in South Africa. Because at that time, our continent was still very dark, as they put it, and we were very much at a disadvantage. It needed somebody with a very big courage to go through all of these rough waters, you know, to try and sort of prepare things for the world at large. She fought. She mixed with women and other people who were in the churches. She mixed with people who worked in the community to bring everybody together to discuss the issues that are at stake with us. And therefore, that in itself, being more people coming together, discussing and fighting together, she found her way in gaining some of the things that we got for ourselves, like the laws, how we should be regarded, how we should be respected, and that we too should